There are many different ways that I could explain this video, but I'm going to use the simple concept of the triune brain to help you demonstrate how well and efficient our brain and body can work together. The triune brain basically means three parts of the brain. The brain stem, which is the primitive part of the brain used for breathing, heart rate, blood pressure. The limbic system, which is the emotional center of the brain, where our emotions get discharged and activated. And then the cortex and the prefrontal cortex, where our conscious control is and where our ego resides to help us direct our daily lives. Now in this video, you're going to see all three parts of the brain play themselves out individually as well as collectively as an integrated organism. Now Matthew just turned on his video camera that was sitting next to him at his desk while he was working because he could feel that something was beginning to surface in him that he wanted to videotape. This behavior itself demonstrates that he was coming from the prefrontal cortex, where he knew consciously and he was in control that something was happening to him. Now we can see that his brainstem has taken over control of his breathing while his cortex is still online, demonstrating that he is an observer and conscious of this experience. Here we can see that he looks at the camera, demonstrating he's conscious once again of what's happening to him. Now this is fascinating as well. The dog Vici comes to the rescue of his master Matthijs. Now what's fascinating about this is that dogs have around the same level of cognition as a 3 to 5 year old human. They're capable of feeling optimism, anxiety, happiness, fear, and depression. And when exposed to emotional stimuli, like the sound of a baby crying, dogs experience emotional pain just as humans do. In this moment of stillness, we can see that something has released and a renegotiation is about to happen in the body. And here comes the crying and the activation of the limbic part of the brain. It's interesting that the dog leaves now because he recognizes that his master is now capable of breathing, and so the threat is over. You can see that the brainstem and limbic system are slowly trying to integrate with the prefrontal cortex, and Matthijs is still in control of this process, both acknowledging the dog as well as following what's happening in his own experience. As his body slowly starts to integrate this intense experience, he starts to calm down in his breathing, but then he still has these tremors deep inside the body that are the residual release of the tension patterns that he just accessed.
That's some life theory right there. I was just doing some work after behind the computer, and I felt the tremoring coming natural, and I just go I try to go with the flow, not caring about ego. That's the hardest part, because you think it's strange to cry at a certain moment, so, or, you know, your breathing goes up, and you just think, why the fuck is my breathing going up? So you just try to control, but then you just let go. And this is just all stuck inside my fascia. It's all just coping shit. It's still going on. It's still holding on, still holding tension, still holding emotion. And you just need to let go. And if you don't TRE more and more, you can set aside ego and you can just let go in what position, what moment in time. And if you're alone, it's very, very nice because it makes it much more easy. And you just start tremoring like a motherfucker, and this tremoring is going on more than 6-7 minutes, and I just thought I was breathing went up and up, and I just, all right, now I have to grab the camera. I have to put it on YouTube or on Instagram or whatsoever, and show you it's okay, you know, it's okay to cry.